Welcome to Between the Covers summer series where we spotlight South Florida authors. I'm Ann Bocock and I'm joined by Eric Rozenberg. He's written a new book, Before It's Too Late, A Love Letter to My Daughters and America. Eric is a Belgian-born entrepreneur, speaker, and author. In 2013, because of prejudice and anti-Semitism, he feared for the safety of his family and left his home country for good for the United States. Thank you for coming. Thank you for speaking with me today. Eric, Belgium was your home.
Yes.
Your wife, your three children. What was the moment that you knew, I can't live here anymore?
Well, thank you, and it hasn't been one moment, but really a series of moments. I was volunteering with the security for the Jewish community in Brussels, and a lot of friends in law enforcement, and they were depicting a country that all my friends in business and politics were not mentioning. And so the first time I told my wife, one day we'll have to leave this country, was in 2002. And then there was a series of events that describe in the book, very different and very horrific. But I think the tipping point for her was on the 11th of January, 2009, when for the first time Israel decided to retaliate against all the missiles that they were getting from Gaza without doing anything. And there were 50,000 Muslims in the street of Brussels chanting, "Dead to Israel, Israel Nazi, dead to the Jews."
Why did you choose the United States? You could have gone anywhere.
Well, yeah, but I've always been an American at heart. And I was very involved with different organizations with the U.S. And I felt that nobody was waiting for us. And as it's a country of immigrants, everybody's always open and ready to help you. And so that's when we finally decided to try to come here. And that's what happened. And we always felt home, became proud Americans today. But it was really a process from the beginning where I thought that with the language, with the culture, with the opportunities that can be here, that was the better place for my family.
The book is, as you call it, a love letter to your daughters and to America. And as I'm reading it, yes, I see that, but I'm also reading this as a cautionary tale. Is that correct?
It's absolutely correct. Unfortunately, I'm seeing some of the same element that I saw in Europe. And I always said, if you have cancer or AIDS, and if you treat one, you're still gonna die from the other. So if you are a Reformed Jew, or if you are a very conservative or Chabad, they will come at you. If you are a Jew which is a Democrat or a Republican, they will come at you. And they, it is on one hand the extreme right, and on the other hand the extreme left. And the similarities that I see with Europe is in the speeches, is with some politicians that are actually saying the same thing, some of the media, but in general, what is totally different, and which is what I love it here, people know what it is, freedom, and people are always ready to discuss, to look at the facts and not just the propaganda, which unfortunately in Belgium is not the case anymore.
By the same token, you write in the book that you witness American Jews as living in a bubble.
Yes, especially in South Florida, I must say. And it's great. I mean, you've been living with no really anti-Semitism for decades. And what I mean by that, very few people here that are Jewish have ever been confronted with, "I'm going to hit you because you're a Jew." You didn't have, like we had, police and with machine gun around the synagogue, even the army protecting Jewish school. And so they've been living in a wonderful environment without really a great awareness of what's going on in Europe and what is slowly starting to resemble to some of the facts that we saw in Europe.
I'm reading your book. I know when you moved to South Florida. Of all the places, you settle in Parkland, and then Valentine's Day 2018 comes and the Parkland school shooting.
Mm-hmm.
Did you think you had made a mistake by moving here?
That's exactly the question that my elder daughter asked me. So she was in the school that day, and thank God was could survive. The next day we sat down and she said, "Dad, if something would have happened to me, would you still be saying that we're safer here in America than in Belgium?" With tough questions. And I look at her, I said, "Listen, darling, first of all, we're very lucky that you're not in one of the 17 people that die and the 17 wounded. And your mother and I are totally convinced that for Jews, it's better in America than it is in Belgium and most of the countries in the world. And there is not 100% safe place in the world. Unfortunately, that's the reality that you have to learn with."
You left Belgium a decade ago.
Yes.
Ever a moment of regret?
Never.
What was the hardest thing that you had to get used to when you moved to the States?
The hardest thing, the way I pronounce some words with my accent. Sometimes I just see the face of the people. Maybe they didn't understand what I wanted to say.
I understand perfectly. I think it's wonderful.
Thank you.
You took the citizenship test. You studied really hard. You got all of the answers right.
Yes.
Give me a word to describe that moment.
Proud, emotional. I remember because it was COVID.
You write a lot about choice in the book. And there is a quote, an Einstein quote at the very end that says, "The world will not be destroyed by those who do evil, but by those who watch them without doing anything." So I'd like to give you the final comment on that, why you chose it and what that means to you.
I do believe in any circumstances, human beings have a choice. We took the choice to leave, despite a lot of people telling us that we were nuts. In any circumstances, you have a choice, and that's what we took. And we took it for our children, and we took it for the next generations. And that's also why I wrote the book, because I wanted my daughters to understand why we did that, but also the next generation and my family will understand that. And any friends in America will be able to know why and how we came here, and why, despite everything, because no country is perfect, this is the greatest country on earth.
Eric Rozenberg's book is Before It's Too Late, A Love Letter to My Daughters and America. Thank you so much for spending some time with me.
Thank you for inviting me.
I'm Ann Bocock. Please join me on the next Between the Covers.